Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. You might think the games get more important as we get deeper into the season. Try selling that to this sellout crowd who's been screaming their guts out and ready for kickoff in the SEC. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
People say it's the toughest place to play in all of college football. We're talking, of course, about the Swamp, Ben Hill Griffin Stadium in Gainesville. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste at zero calories. Enjoy everything. Open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. Bell from the two at the corner, the 50, big opening, and a huge touchdown play. That was some play by the special teams. He hits the PAT. Florida to kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Alabama's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively, but when you got a wide receiver like this, it really helps the cause.
It does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups, and when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find a one-on-one matchup, and if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
Second and eight, ball on their own 22. They'll get him in the backfield. Loss of two on the run by the halfback. They're one of the loudest crowds in the country, and they are on their feet. Pass complete and taken down immediately. Wilson is the putter. He's at midfield. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Florida is up seven. Tackle at the 44.
Gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
From the 44-yard line, it's second down. Nice nice run up the middle. The catch and look out. Tackle around the 29-yard line.
Not every offense uses their tight ends very effectively, but when they do, it can be a nightmare for a defense.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. Slings it. Tackle made at the 19. What a play.
Boy, solid job there by the quarterback, recognizing the defensive coverage and delivering the ball to the open receiver.
They'll bring him down right around the 16-yard line. Jordan gets around three on the halfback draw.
With the safeties coming up making plays near the line of scrimmage, that tells your offense they've got to start throwing the ball to keep them honest.
From the 16-yard line, second down. They line up in the jumbo set. Runs it, and he stops short of the line of scrimmage.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. Third down.
Florida is up by a touchdown.
Ready.
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
So it's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Florida is hoping to make this a two-score game. Kicks away, and it is good. Like they're ready for the kickoff. Butler from the 7. Tackle at the 29-yard line. Florida's defense got the stop they wanted on that first drive. Now let's see if they can do it again.
And just listen to this crowd, Brad. I mean, you can practically feel the energy coming down from the crowd and how it's impacting these players.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. He is drilled at the 38.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. He's brought down in the open field.
That's a gain of three on the play. That makes it first and ten.
They come out on an empty backfield. He steps out around the 43-yard line. Well, a new quarterback, but we saw this kid getting reps both in practice and in the pregame walkthrough, so this isn't a big surprise. From their own 43-yard line, second down. Again with a carry. And down he goes at about the 43-yard line.
That makes it 37.
One of the top stadiums in the nation. This crowd comes to play themselves. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. Bring it into the first quarter of action. The Gators with a 10-point lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Bell, back to return it. He drops it. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He's to the 40. Oh, and he had some steam on that throw. Brought down at the 42-yard line.
Looks like the defense played the run that time. With this offense, you've got to be ready for a pass on any down in any situation.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 42. They'll work the left side, and he's taken down at the 45.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Man left, man left. Three down. Mike 51.
Ready!
And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line.
Gain 2 yards. That'll make it 35.
From their own 47-yard line, third down.
Ready! Green 88! Green!
That's going to bring up fourth down.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
Herbie went to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury. We still don't know the severity, but the bad news is he hasn't reappeared. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
They make the stop at the 23.
Timmons is the kind of impact player that every team in the country would love to have on their team. And we've seen some early film on him. Kirk and I, you know, we looked at it. He looks legit, but we'll see if it translates to real competition.
From their own 23-yard line, second down.
Is
out to the tailback on the screen, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 26-yard line. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
These fans are showing you why teams hate to come here, folks. He's out of bounds at about the 31. Wilson to punt. And he mucked it. Brought down to the 39-yard line. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here. Here's the throw to the fullback. He's taken down around the 44-yard line.
That makes it second and 6.
It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. He's tackled at about the 45.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Ready!
Around 5 yards on the delayed handoff. From the 40-yard line, it's second down.
Mike 51.
Quick throw to the tight end. And and he's tackled around the 25-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
From the 25-yard line, first down. Got a man, watch out here. Tackle at the 17. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Knocked out of bounds at the 10. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Fires quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. It was an 8-play, 60-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. So the score now, 17-0. Florida kicked this one off. Butler from the 5. He's out to the 30, and he's taken down at the 33. Henry's having all kinds of troubles in this first half, and normally he's having a big game when you're almost at halftime, and he's almost non-existent in this offense. And, Kirk, you got to wonder whether he's 100% healthy or not.
We'll have to take a look and see if EA can come up with an answer to that, but he just doesn't look like himself. I mean, you know, physically, mentally, something just doesn't seem right. And right now this team's going to have to try to rely on some other players to be able to step up their game and see if they can get back and have a chance to win this game.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. Throws this one out to the left.
And I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
Really a tough spot for an offense to be in against this crowd in this stadium. He's hit and taken down.
If you're the defense, who do you try to cover this guy with? He's too fast for most linebackers. He's too big for most corners. You have to rely on your safeties, who generally aren't very good in one-on-one coverage.
Caught out in the open. And they push him out at the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 38.
Three down. And he's getting the ball.
Scrambling around. Tackle made at the 34. The quarterback trying to make a play.
Well, he did a nice job of getting some yards there on the scramble, but he needs to learn to slide to avoid those big hits.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. They'll bring him down right around the 26-yard line.
Gain of 8 on the play.
Check.
That makes it first and 10.
Omaha.
Hey, check 24. Watch 24.
Here we go. Green 88. Green.
And he hits him hard at the 2.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
Let's go! Green 19! Green!
Quick throw, caught, touchdown!
like the call here. Well executed by the offense. You want to be sure you get 6 points when you're this close to the goal line.
And he adds the extra point. An 8-play, 66-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
So our score, 17-7. Fielded at the 4. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop him this time.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. 17-7. Florida.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Ball security was a major theme coming into this game, and both offensive coordinators have to be thrilled with the fact that their offenses, first and foremost, did a good job of taking care of the ball.
And you don't see it every game, that's for sure, that both teams don't have a turnover at the half. And you usually see those critical mistakes that set up a short field for you to take advantage of. And it's definitely nice. It's nice to be able to put in a plan all throughout the week and to be able to execute it and not to be able to make those big mistakes. Because coaches will tell you, it's those big mistakes that kill you. It's okay to be rushed in the pocket as a quarterback and then throw it to your mom in the third row. Don't throw it in harm's way. Both quarterbacks done a good job, and as a result, both teams with zero turnovers in the first half.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He goes out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 27. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And down he goes at the 35.
First down.
Pitch out, got the corner. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. The halfback loses about one on the option. Second and 11. Ball on their own 34. Brought down around the 40-yard line.
Gain of 6 yards. Third down.
Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
Bell is back awaiting the punt. He's out to the 30. Tackle at the 35-yard line. Quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play.
Get down, get down. Mike, 51,
has it on the corner. He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Gets out to around the 45. He gets to about the 31-yard line. From the 31-yard line. First down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he's taken down around the 26-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
Gets to about the 24-yard line.
Two yards. That makes it third and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Nice run there.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
They line up in the jumbo set. He gets out to about the 18-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. This is the ninth play of this drive. They're crowding the line.
Football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
And he tacks on the extra point. King looks ready to kick this one off. He'll return this one from the 7. Tackle made at the 27. You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away.
Down 2 possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He steps up. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Call it a gain of 9 yards. First down.
Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it. From their own 42-yard line, second down. He makes it to the 45-yard line.
Jazz lead is 17.
Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. This crowd can really be intimidating for an opposing team. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Quick strike to the receiver. And they make the stop at the 29-yard line.
That's a gain of 26 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From the 29-yard line, it's first down. On the catch. Oh, they strip it out. Here's the eighth play of the series. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted. Third down, and they need to get it to the 19. I don't know if they'll be able to hear his cadence in the midst of all this mayhem. Quick throw, almost intercepted. They'll spread the field with five wide. They hook up over the middle.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
Nine times out of ten, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Here he goes. Makes it out to about the 39. At midfield. He's taken down at about the 41. It's first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Run, and he's brought down.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and 6.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
A yard, if that, on the quarterback keeper.
That'll bring up third and 6.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31.
Three down. 51, Mike. Mike, 51.
Ready. Green 90.
Green
He's out of bounds.
At about the 33-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense. We're about set to start things up again. Tackle at the 46. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Throws it to the outside. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. From their own 46-yard line, it's second down. They come out in a five-wide set. He sails it long. It's picked off. He's tackled around the 38-yard line.
I really like this corner's ability to read the play. He shows very good football smarts and pretty good hands, too.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. And he's tackled around the 28-yard line. They come out in a goal line set. Hands up the middle and stuffed. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. They'll take it inside, but the defense is ready. Up the broadcast. What do you have to say about how this game turned out, Kirk?
You know, I think it was a well-played game for the most part. Alabama had a few missed opportunities in this game, and I think if they could have capitalized on a few of them, it would have been a lot closer, and they might even have won this game.
This broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.